Hold tight and welcome to this plumberparts.co.uk video all about these lovely little fittings. We're going to go to that video any minute now, but before we do, I'd love it if you could please subscribe to this video by clicking on the link that's appearing now. Those links are available throughout the video for you to click on anytime, and as I've said before, they'll completely enhance your whole feeling of this video. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it, everyone, and hold tight.
plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.
So then, you've obviously found this video because you want to look and find out about how these little fittings work and how MDPE pipe works. Now, MDPE pipe stands for medium density polyethylene, which to plumbers and people like you means absolutely nothing. All you need to know is that it's used by your water supplier to supply water up to your property. Now, you'll often find it in either 20mm or 25mm sizes. It's really, really easy to work with. These fittings are absolutely brilliant. They're bomb proof. Once they're in, they're perfectly fine. So what I'm going to do is show you exactly how they work. I'm just fitting a small ATPLAS chamber at my property here today, so I'm going to show you exactly how you can use them when you're actually out and about on site. So I hope you enjoy this video today, guys, and remember to hold tight. Right then, so we've got a few different types of fittings here. We've got a 25mm to 3/4 male thread on here, so that can go into any kind of iron fitting. We've also got a standard 20mm straight coupling. And we've also got a 20mm to 1/2 inch iron as well. So it gives you a good idea about how they work. Also, we've got a little bit of blue 20mm here. As you can see, it's very easy to cut if you've got some cutters like that. And you get a really nice clean cut on that if you use proper cutters. You can use a hacksaw on it, that's totally fine. Now, just looking at the pipe before we continue, often you'll find when you're on site or you're working or something like that, the builders have probably put this in beforehand and they've pushed it around through a, you know, a breeze block wall or something like that, and it's got all scored. So what I'd say is a very good idea when you're actually going to be fitting any of these fittings to feel around the pipe itself and just see if there's any sort of scratches or scores in it. If there are, grab yourself a Stanley knife and drag it, put your Stanley blade almost like right angles to the pipe itself and just drag that up that. And what that tends to do is just clean that off and flatten it out and smooth it out. That always helps. And obviously a great idea as well is to have a rasp for these so you can just rasp out any burrs and flatten off the ends. Now, before we continue with anything like this, if you're doing any of this sort of work, you're fitting any of these fittings, be sure to buy the corresponding inserts to go with it. So you can pop these on there like that, and that'll actually protect the pipe from being crushed when you tighten up your fitting later on in the job. So let's just have a look at a standard one of these fittings. If we unscrew the compression nut, what you'll expose is a small clamp. Now you'll see, you'll notice there's a taper on this clamp here, and there's a corresponding taper inside the compression nut. So when this screws down, when the compression nut screws down around on this thread, that's going to force down and bite on this clamp, and also bite slightly on the rubber inside here, and make a watertight seal, and make sure that your pipe doesn't pop out when it's under pressure. We just pop this bit out here. You'll see inside there, with that little white dot on it, you've got your little rubber seal. They're a strange sort of shape. They're not completely round. They're kind of flattened off on each side, but that sits in there like so. Then this sits here like that, and then our nut sits on here. The way to do it is to make sure you can see a couple of threads on here. They're completely undone. Get yourself your pipe like so, pop your insert in it just like that, and then you'll be able to push this right in here, and that'll feel a little bit wibbly wobbly, a little bit loose. Now what you want to do is just tighten this up. You can almost tighten these fittings up by hand and they'll create a pretty good seal just then. But really what you want to do is grab yourself a set of grips, nice set of grips, grab the fitting itself like so, and then get another set of grips on this nut here and then tighten that up as you would do a normal compression fitting. So if you like to recap, you've got your insert pops in here like this. You have your nut, your actual clamp, your rubber seal on there like so, and that all fits together. I mean, you could even put them together like this, even though I don't recommend it. And once you've tightened this up, even if you do it by hand, you wouldn't believe how much of a clamp that gets. It's absolutely fantastic fitting. Well done, Philmac, well done. So sometimes you'll find as well, it's quite difficult with suppliers to find the right sort of fittings for what you want. And we've got that problem on this job here. The ATPLAS chamber we're fitting has got a female 3/4 inch thread on it. And unfortunately, we're going on to 20mm pipe like this. I went down the suppliers and they didn't have any of the particular fittings we needed. And it's one of them things, like, I've got to get the job done. So don't worry, they've already thought up this particular problem. If you whip apart, this is a large 25mm here. We're going to get it down to 20mm. You can take out the gubbins here and buy, they're usually in the same place, a reducer. It's just like using a 22 to 15 mil compression reducer or a solder one, so that's brilliant. If you look at it closely, what we've got is a small rubber O-ring on here. We've got the same kind of clamp arrangement and other O-ring inside this insert. We've taken apart the bigger fitting, So we're going to pop this, and this just pops in there just like that. There we go, in there just like so. And the great thing is that when you press down on this, it presses down on the clamp as well. So you can pop your 20mm pipe in here just like that. Tighten that up and bang, you reduce your 25mm pipe to 20mm. And we've got a connection ready for our ATPLAS chamber that we're going to change in a minute. One thing I would say about all these fittings is kind of a little bit of a tip, is that they tend to not have a huge taper on the thread on here. So they don't tend to really tighten up very well. So it's just up here like so. Make sure your PTFE runs the right way. It has to run the direction of which way you're going to be doing it in. I mean, we've done a video on PTFEing and how to do it. It's really easy. I always put a fair bit on these right at the end of the thread to almost act like a big fat sort of washer. Another little tip I'll give you as well is try to not have too much PTFE on the first threads, because it is plastic, and if the thread starts to have trouble and goes cross-threaded, especially if it's in a brass fitting, you're going to completely ruin one of these, and they aren't cheap. You can start your PTFE at the first thread, but make sure you start building up repetitive threads further back, so then it can get a nice start, a good old grip on that thread, and be okay. You spin me right round, baby, right round, like a record player, right round, round, round. Right then, so here's where we're working. We've got our ATPLAS chamber here with our threads in it. There's a little arrow on these as well, which denotes which way the water should flow through it. So we're going to be putting it in this way round, because our mains is coming from over there. It's popping through here like that and then going into the house. At the moment, there's a temporary meter in here that's got a little bit of copper on it as well. Now, the thing I've got to point out to you as well is that the copper on here is actually kind of internal normal copper. It's not going to work. You can't use like standard house copper to go in the ground nowadays, because basically it can get rotted through by the acids in the earth. If you look at any of the old copper mains they put back, you know, about in the 50s or something, you'll see the wall thickness of that copper when you cut through it with your pipe size is so thick. It's incredible. So what we're going to do, we've got a little bit of blue going in here, and at the moment that's going on a straight 20mm to half inch female. That's going to be changed over for just a straight coupling. Then we're going to extend our blue pipe. We've got some blue here. We're going to pop our ATPLAS chamber just in behind us and then link that to the blue pipe that's going off back to the mains. So what I've got to do quickly now is just go around next door where the main stop tap is and turn that off. Got that done. Right, so the next thing I'm going to do is I'm just going to pop on my two unions on here, as you can see. I just screw in nicely like that. Right, so we've got our chamber in position roughly where I want to put it. We've got our two connections screwed in here, nice and happy. So all I've really got to do, it's so simple. Like I said, fill this pipe, make sure it's not scored or damaged or anything. The seals on these are really quite good at getting a decent seal on it, so it should be okay. And really all I've got to do is cut that pipe back to the length I'd like it to be at. Don't ever cut too much off, because we can't add it on. I think we're going to be pretty good with the length we've got there already. So I'm going to pop my insert in, just like so, like that. And I'm actually going to lift this out and I'll pop that in there. I hope you can see this all okay. Like that. I'm just going to nip that up a little bit and then grab a proper set of grips. Give that a good nip up now. This wants to be pretty tight. And then what I might have to do, I don't really want to get any poo inside the actual chamber itself. So what I might have to do is just dig out a little bit more here. So we've got a nice little sort of sweeping run up so it goes nice and straight into that coupling. So what I'm going to do, because I've got my ATPLAS chamber laying here out and ready, I'm just going to have a look at this pipe here. It's a bit old, we've got a few little bits on it, just needs scraping off, just like so. Just make sure it's nice and clean. You know, don't cut it like that, otherwise what you're going to do is cause a problem, aren't you? Just try and brush it across there. I find this is a really good way of sorting these out. Find out how far it is to it needs to be fully home, and then pop your thumb next to it, and then you'll know exactly how far you've got to push the pipe. Sorry guys, had a bit of a delay there. Unfortunately, I've just been called out. And then I've bloody got back and it was getting late, so we had to stop for a little while, so I just had to make this up quickly, otherwise next door wouldn't have their water on. Chris would start moaning. So yeah, the water is back off again, so I just got to pretty much start again. It's actually quite a good thing that we've had that, because now you'll be able to see how easy these come apart as well when you need to do any work with them. It should be nice and easy, like a Sunday morning. That's being cut just about here. And as you've seen already, mark that with the old thumb, the trusty thumb. Like a quick snip through. Give that a nice little feel, just make sure there's no scores on it. That's feeling pretty good. So just pop that on in here. Lift that lot up. And then So get that last little nip. The body like that. These have got a neoprene insert on these, and they can be easy to break actually. So you want to watch them. You don't want to ring off your neoprene, otherwise you're going to be getting yourself another ATPLAS chamber and starting all over again. So, I mean, regardless of whether this video is actually about the, Mdpe pipe, if you are fitting an ATPLAS chamber, they usually come new ones without the bung. So you're going to want to go online and grab yourself a bung as well. And what you do, you pop that in and then you can use it for the couple of days or whatever it is until the water board come along and actually wind your meter in. So we're just going to pop that in here. Right, so now it should just be able to go back out to the road, turn this water back on, then we can test all this for leaks. And then once we're happy there's no leaks, we can backfill it, pop our telescopic extender on, and then you're waiting for the patio guys to come along, clear all this lot out, level it all off nice, and then, you know, make your patio up. And then you'll just have a standard ATPLAS chamber in there that'll look really great and be really easy to get to, really easy to read the meter, and also really easy for anyone, like the householder, to be able to turn the water off and everything like that. So then, there we go, we've got it all in, it's all covered over, as you can see. Now I've got a nice little chamber there. God. Anyway, I hope you've enjoyed this plumberparts.co.uk video. I hope it's given you a better idea about how MDPE fittings actually work. And also, I mean, showing you a little bit about how to do an ATPLAS chamber, what they are, and how easy they are to fit if you've got a nice trench dug out already. If you need any more help or any more information, please visit our website at plumberparts.co.uk. And do remember to follow us on Facebook and Twitter by clicking on the button that's appearing right now. Anyway, I'll see you in our next video, which is probably going to be more plumbing disasters that you guys have sent in. And remember, everybody, to hold tight. See you later. Well, it means nothing to me. Oh, Vienna.
Plumberparts.co.uk. Honest reviews and advice.